Hello everyone, I'm at Haw River State Park today with my friend Heidi. She's going to introduce us to the North Carolina state reptile, the Eastern Box Turtle. So can you help us find one today?
I can. First, we need to find an Eastern Box Turtle. Here at Haw River State Park, we track them using radio telemetry.
What exactly is radio telemetry?
Radio telemetry is technology that utilizes radio signals to track animals. There are three basic components. There's the transmitter, there's the receiver, and there's the antenna. The transmitter is attached to the turtle, and it's attached in such a way that it doesn't affect the turtle's daily task, but it's sending out a radio signal that we can't hear, but when I turn on the receiver and the antenna, we'll be able to hear a clicking sound.
So are we currently tracking any turtles at the park?
We are tracking two this year. Shall we go track a turtle?
Let's go.
All right.
Right now, we're currently tracking the Eastern Box Turtle. Why is it important to track the turtles?
By using radio telemetry, we collect data that can help us learn how box turtles interact with their environment. Scientists have found that populations of Eastern Box Turtles are lower in areas with a lot of development, like roads and buildings. And by collecting all of this information, scientists can teach us how to better protect the Eastern Box Turtle populations.
Do you think we're getting close?
I think we're very close. In fact, I think he is right over there.
We found the Eastern Box Turtle. Wow, he's got a really beautiful shell.
The Eastern Box Turtle's domed shell is an amazing physical adaptation that protects them from predators. The shell is part of the skeletal system and is made up of bone. The outside of the shell is covered in scutes. These scutes are, it's the colored portion of the shell that we can see, and they're made out of keratin, which is the same material as our fingernails are made out of. These scutes are colored in such a way that it allows the turtle to camouflage within its environment. The top of the shell is called the carapace, and the bottom of the shell is the plastron. The Eastern Box Turtle's plastron is unique. It has a hinge that allows the turtle to pull their entire body into their shell and then close as a defense against predators. This closing up is how they protect themselves. It's a behavioral adaptation.
What are the natural predators of the Eastern Box Turtle?
Well, thanks to this hard camouflage shell, adult Eastern Box Turtles do not have many predators. Animals like raccoons and foxes will eat Eastern Box Turtle eggs and juveniles.
Where can Eastern Box Turtle be found?
We find them throughout North Carolina in a variety of habitats, from forest to meadows, even suburban backyards. Eastern Box Turtles live in what we call a home range. These home ranges vary in size from 2.5 acres up to about 12 acres. To give you an idea, a small Eastern Box Turtle range would be about the size of 1 or 2 football fields. These home ranges provide the box turtle with all the food, water, and shelter that they need. They are as familiar with their home range as we are with our home and our neighborhood.
Is a state park a good place to find them?
Absolutely. State parks provide great habitat for the Eastern Box Turtle. We have a lot of wilderness area, so there's not as much development. There's not as many roads or fences or buildings. Plus, state parks provide excellent natural food sources for the Eastern Box Turtle.
What do they eat?
Eastern Box Turtles are what we call omnivores. That means they eat a wide variety of plants and animals. The Eastern Box Turtle will eat berries, grasses, mushrooms, insects, snails, slugs. Speaking of mushrooms, snails, and slugs, I'm getting kind of hungry. I think it's close to lunchtime, and I think this guy probably is too. Maybe we should let him go about his turtle business.
That sounds like a plan. I really enjoy tracking the turtles, so let's go.